China officially has 56 ethnic groups, and one of them is the ethnic Manchus. Like some ethnic minorities, the Manchus have become increasingly indistinguishable from the predominant ethnic Han majority, and some Manchus are battling to keep their language and culture alive.
In 1644, the Manchus conquered China and established the Qing dynasty, one of the world's richest and most powerful empires. For over 300 years, the descendants of nomadic tribesmen were the undisputed leaders until the dynasty crumbled in 1911. Even as the ruling class, the Manchus had adopted various aspects of Han customs, language, and culture. And in the aftermath of the various political storms and persecution sweeping through China, few Manchus dared to assert their ethnic identities.
Some say it's inevitable, even a matter of time, before the Manchu language is completely lost and forgotten. But some are determined to keep the language, as well as culture, alive.
This group in downtown Beijing hopes to save the ancient language from extinction. It conducts regular language and culture classes. The desire for language preservation also stems from the way Manchus are portrayed in contemporary Chinese history.
因为有这样的一个教育嘛，就觉得说是满族人，然后造成是满族人造成这个中国的这么多年的落后，所以就觉得好像所有的账都算在满族人身上，然后就会去关心说到底我们以前那个历史是怎么样的。But
keeping the language alive is an uphill battle.
英文或者是汉语这样的一个成熟的语言，日语这样的语言，它到现在没有断代。 所有的这个现代的用语和现代的语汇词汇都是一直在延续下来的，但是满语它有一个断层的一个过程，整体语言这个水平的话，远远没有英语和汉语这样的一个发达的。Then
there's also the question of parents not wanting their children to be burdened by learning an extra language in an already competitive education system. So bleak is the future of the Manchu language that even Manchu experts believe that the language will disappear in about a decade. If so, it will most likely serve as a cautionary tale to other ethnic minorities. Maria Xiao, China News Asia, in Beijing.